Everybody, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for being here today. I am going to share with you guys a little bit in my A5 six ring binder where I have started to do planning for just for fun more than anything, but really because I want to be able to carry this one with me in my happy planner, which I have all my work information in. I can't always carry it with me because I keep some personal information and such. So I will share this travel planner as I plan with it for this week of Valentine's. I'm using this really cute, pretty kit from Willow Fields. It's a huge kit, so actually I only end up using a part of it. My inserts are from So Much Crafting. I will be posting a link to them down below, and also a link for Willow Fields. And the planner itself, I bought at Hobby Lobby. I think it's called Studio 52, and they have some super cute planners. And I like this one because I have the eyelashes on the inside. Even though I'm not much of a blue person, I do like light blue and teal a little bit. So let's get started with this week. I actually have mostly writing to do this week. I just got back from a reader's event. So this week I have to play catch up, do some writing. I have a bunch of social functions in the evening, so I have to make sure that I get my stuff done during the day so that I can enjoy my evenings. So what I'm doing right now, going through all the stickers. Like I said, this kit is huge and can be a little bit overwhelming. I have to decide which parts to use. And then my leftover parts that I have, I will be using those for my personal planner that I will be carrying with me. All right, so I have these little headers that I got from the GPC studio, and I wanted to use that to kind of just cover up the words that are on there just to make it a little bit prettier. And so that's what I'm doing now. I'm covering up work, and I'm actually just putting another thing that says work on there and adding a little cover for the one for the daily tasks, and I'm also covering that up. I like that because you can list your daily task, and then every day of the week you check off whether or not you get things done, like social media, Facebook, Instagram, water, drinking, you know, if you have to make certain phone calls, check your email, post on groups, that kind of thing. You can put it down on your daily tasks and then check it off as you do it every day. It keeps you kind of accountable. So I do love that part of this specific set by So Much Crafting. They have a ton of different sets, so you can kind of go through there and find the one that works the best for you. The only thing I will warn you about this paper is not only is it buttery soft, but once you put a sticker down, you better be careful about pulling it back up. Have your undo right there at your elbow so that you can fix things. So what kind of keeps me on track is to have my to-do list across the top so that it draws my eye to the things that I have to get done. And since they're right there, I can just go to them and just, you know, write down what I have to do every day. And then when I come back to it, I can just kind of check off things. So I love having my to-dos across the top of all my planners. I always do that. And this planner, I mostly have my personal things. I don't have work-related stuff as much because, like I said, I carry it with me. So if an appointment comes up, things like that, I jot it down. Or, you know, usually it's that week that is planned. So I can look up that week and say, okay, this is what's going on Monday through Friday. It's a week, more of a weekly planner than anything else. I do carry a personal pocket planner. When just for every day in my purse, I just jot things down. And that one's messy. It's all just ink where I will write down things like, you know, I have a appointments and all that. I have that one that is just a little simple pocket planner for that. So this one is just like if I'm traveling, I want to have a planner with me, or if I'm going to planner meetups or meeting with friends and I want to, you know, just discuss the current week, I use it. But like I said, it's mostly more for fun than anything else. I just love having my pretty planners. All right, so what I have going on this week as far as work goes, and most of us know as writers, we always set goals. So I have a goal of 2,000 words a day. I'm keeping it on low because I have so much to do. So I'm setting my goal for writing 10,000 words for the week, which is 2,000 a day, Monday through Friday. I also have a book that is due that I'm sending to my editor to get edited. I'm getting that done this week. I am also releasing my newsletter. I try to get my newsletter out of the middle of the month, and I'm doing a newsletter swap with another author, which means that she is going to put up one of my books in her newsletter, and I'm going to put up one of her books in my newsletter. So I have to make sure to do it justice and do that right. So I have that going on this week. I also have an important phone call that I make every Monday with my accountability partner. We keep each other in check, and I just love doing that. And then I also have to prepare for a big convention next week. So I have to start getting that stuff all packed up and staged and make sure if I need any last minute things ordered that I go ahead and order them now. I have to pay out the butt for shipping because I waited to the last minute on some things, but you know, that's how it goes. So anyway, that's the kind of stuff I have going on as far as my writing goes. So that will be, that is on my personal, not my personal, I'm sorry, on my writing planner that I keep on my desk. So my writing goals for the day, newsletter, what I'm sending off to my editor, last minute edits in that book that I will be doing before I send it to him. And yeah, so this is what I pre-planned so far in this one. So let me tell you what's going on here, besides using Undo. I don't know why I'm taking that off because I'm looking at, I think I may make them a little shorter because they're kind of tall. Or did I give up? I think I gave up and just put my washi over it. I wanted to add that I forgot about the sparkly washi. And so I wanted to make sure that I had enough room and that box was a little too long. So I ended up cutting it and making it a little shorter after I put the washi down and decorated a little bit because I like to have a little sparkle in my planner. And so I added washi there and then I add a little bit more at the top of the page. And then actually end up picking up that washi and making it into little arrows. So yeah, I am surprised I didn't tear these pages up. as far as my social life goes, on Tuesday night, I have my girls coming over because we're planning a big meetup and they're coming over Tuesday night to discuss what we're doing. On Wednesday night, I'm supposed to be going to the movies with my husband. That's still up in the air. On Thursday, I have our Bible study that my husband leads that we will be doing. And then on Friday night, I have book club, which has been meeting for like 14 years. And then on Saturday, I have my planner meetup, which I am hosting. And then by Sunday, I will be so tired I won't know my name. So that's my plans for the week. Thank you so much for tuning in. And I hope you have a wonderful week. Bye.